1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. One foot on the mountain, the other one in the street. All kinds of trouble, and I'm caught in between. I can't change my way of doing. It's gonna lay like it falls. If I can't go down rocking, ain't gonna go down that tall. She was a child of the quiet money, had that silver spoon. I knew she had a little wild streak, leading, breathing room. I can't be your sugar daddy, I won't be your Neanderthal. If I can't go down rocking, ain't gonna go down that road. Spent a little time in the congregation, that's how I was raised. Spent a little time in trouble, but I do have my way. If I can't go down rockin', they ain't gonna go down that
road. Ain't gonna go down, ain't gonna go.
Might I have good intentions, crawling into bed, resting my body, clearing my head. Just about midnight, I got that telephone call. If I can't go down rocking, I ain't gonna go down there at all. That's how I was born. Spent a little time in trouble, but I do have my way. I won't be your Neanderthal. I can't go down rocking, ain't gonna go down that road.
Well, there's the first one down. Hard to believe that little pile makes an 18-foot grain bin, but it does. Thing, all things considered, being the first time, thing didn't really didn't go that bad. Took almost as long to get the jack set up and everything ready to go as it did to actually tear the bin down, because once we got rolling, Dad and Granddad got the door pulled out while Corey, Mark, and I were setting up the jacks. And when we first got there, it took us, well, they, Dad and Mark and Granddad started going around the base of the bin, peeling off the 4 or 5 layers of tar that had been applied to it over the years. And I went inside and started numbering panels, got the roof jack set up and all that stuff. And then, like I say, Dad and Granddad started pulling door out and got the first row of bolts out while Corey and Mark and I were setting the bin jacks up and getting those ready to roll. And from the time we made our first lift to the time we had the first ring sitting on the ground was only about 15 minutes a ring. It didn't take long at all once we got rolling. And then slowed down a little bit when we got to the roof just because we had to figure out how the heck it came apart. But that was a good, that little 18 footer was a good one to get the pattern down. Jacks worked good. Have to do a little bit of adjusting to my lifting brackets because they were trying to twist a little bit. So have to do a little bit of work to those, but shouldn't be too bad. Need to replace one pulley on one of the A-frames because it's cracked. And then get that taken care of and should be ready to go. Hopefully get the last two down next weekend. It's that 24 footer with the stirrator and it's going to be an all day project. That 21 footer shouldn't take long at all. It's just like this one minus the tar and all the bullshit. And I'm going to go, I got to drive right past there on the way home from work during the week. So I'm going to swing by probably tomorrow. The weather's supposed to be decent. I'm going to swing by the 24 footer on the way home from work, and I gotta pull a light off, and I'm gonna bust the rest of the tar off around that, and pull all the wires off for the bin spreader and all that crap, and it should go pretty quick with all that stuff out of the way. It'll basically just be setting the jacks up and start pulling. But can't remember where I was going with that now. It's been a long week. Hell of a way to end a week like I just had, but next week, hopefully. I would have got started a whole lot earlier today, but I really wanted to see what the weather was going to do first because I didn't want to tell everybody, hey, show up here at 6 o'clock in the morning so we can get rolling and then have thunderstorms come in. So we got started about, I think it was exactly 9 o'clock when we pulled in the driveway over there. And we had this whole thing down on the ground by, I think when I checked my phone, it was 12:20 when we had the whole thing in pieces laying on the ground. So not too bad. Took over 3 hours. And that was with trying to figure out what to do. So hopefully, like I say, the big ones will go pretty quick, especially if I get all the bullshit work out of the way on the 24 footer. The 21 footer never had any tar on it, so it should be good to go. But didn't hardly have any stubborn bolts. Most of them didn't even need a wrench on the outside, just spun them off with the impact. There was a handful we had to have a wrench for, but wasn't too bad. Roof jack worked good. So anyway, one down, two to go. I guess that does it for this one. We'll catch you guys on the next one.